Okay. We thought over the migration from TinyOPS to LibreOPS. I'm the developer of the team, that's my chef, and that's the junior from the travel guide from Michael Müller Verlag, who used the TinyOPS, and in future he would use the LibreOPS. We changed TinyOPS because we have the old system use Word 2003 with custom XML nodes, and that not works yet. So we use now LibreOPS and use somit LibreOffice and change the book, use RDF Notes architecture with bookmarks for show our some things we need for our books, e-books and web app, and sorry, it's my first presentation for too much people, sorry. And here is the first solution of our task pane. Oh God. It's our for our task pane, which you need for some fixes. When we got the document from the Verlag, we must do bookmarks to refer some things to create later the books, and we need halt LibreOPS to fix some things or add some details to the some things, and that's the first production from the old system to LibreOffice. This is another view from that, and that also, and I develop on SciSharm. I use it for our extension, and the basic from our extension is UnUnit, heißt es, which has Laszlo give us to, and I created our views and windows and other things, and yeah, and for the migration we use a documents with comments, and these comments we created to bookmarks in code, as a via code with a button, and so the old documents were not failed, or the information from our old documents were rescued to the new system. Yes.
Yes, let me say something around why we did that. In the past, we used Microsoft Office Word 2003, and that is now 20 years old. And the problem is you cannot use it, you cannot say, don't touch a running system. That don't work in the future. We tried something, we packaged Microsoft Word in some VMs for Mac, for Windows. We packaged MSIX system from Microsoft, and we packaged with a VMware Synapse, and we tried anything to have the Word running and running again, but it's not so easy to have lived that. And our workflow was working now with this old Word. We have to change that to the LibreOffice, because that's the only one, maybe what we can have in the own hand in the future for us. Yeah. And now we migrate this old custom XML architecture to the RDF system. And we migrated with the special node, and I will say some thanks to Armin Legrand, because we did discuss together some ideas how we can let going run this migration from these old documents to the LibreOffice system. Okay.
Yes. No, I don't hear. I hear it first now, but I'm not, only the developer.
Okay. The problem is we need to have the layout. The layout the same, and the problem is only to use the XML standard. It's not so easy to migrate to the same layout. We have to let the layout and use it further in the next LibreOffice. Yes, and that's the problem. You have some these custom XML tags, technology. You have some attributes in the database, and we are in the right with the special task pane. We are connected with databases. We're saving some information, and we putting that back to the document. And after this working with these special documents, we get an C# publisher to read all these documents and produce stuff for the app databases, e-books, on whatever we want, digital products. That's the problem.